Hello everyone, welcome to my new video, and today I want to show you my script which enhanced that tag all option. And my idea for this script is that that partial automatically process of tagging should be a little bit smarter, and here I put a tag on those elements to show section value, and basically the section value will not change if you don't change, for example, size. If you change the size for the element, all other numbers of the section will also change. And I did use this rule that Revit performs when you're changing parameters for the elements in order to perform smarter tagging. And in general, my logic, for example, for this part here is that you can only put one tag and that will be sufficient, because other three elements does not have any difference in the matter of size, height, and they don't have any other ducts connected to them. But also you need to know that Revit will not put a new section value even when you change the height. So here we have a duct with size 400 with 300 millimeters, elevation is 3.2 meters. Then when you change the elevation, the section number will remain the same. So that is why I add that extra field in my user interface to check for those situations. And now let's compare tag all option and my script. So for example, if we tag all pipes in our view, we will have, let's see, 46 pipe tags. Now, if we run my script, we need to choose the system. So my script will not automatically tag anything. You need to decide which system do you want to tag. You can say if you want to ignore elements with a length less than and the number that you choose. If you want, you can check for that height differences, and you can delete all existing tags. And you will delete all existing tags for only that system. So now we did perform a tagging for a hydronic return. And now I will again run my script in order to tag that hydronic supply. Let's go with the same value, ignore all elements which length is less than 300 millimeters, check for height, delete existing tags. And now if I select all my elements in order to see how many pipe tags I have only 33 tags. And now if you need to rearrange all the tags, you will have less work to do. That is the case number one. Case number two is this kind of situation. If you have duct, you don't have any change for other three ducts. My opinion is that you only need to tag one element, and the Revit will give you four tags for this case. So now I will delete existing tags, and after that I will run my script. Now I want to tag return error for ducts. This usually does not make any sense. I don't want to check the height, and already I deleted all the tags, and now I have only one tag. And later, if for example I change my size, and now I want to run my script again, again it's return error, I didn't change the height, delete all existing, and now I have two tags. That's it. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Thank you.